It's a story of discrimination.
Oh, yeah, exactly, yeah.
But why?
Why? Discrimination exists in every people. I mean, you know, if you have people, you have discrimination. It's an animal thing. I think among the animal kingdom also, you know, if you're odd-looking sheep, you will be, how do you say, ostracized by the other people. A funny-looking chicken or a funny-looking duck, anything. It's part of the human nature, the discrimination.
When I was 24, I decided I can't stay in this country where I'm always being referred to as a Jap. I want to find out who I am. I got the GI Bill. I applied for a school in Paris. I got to Paris in September 48.
So this is our place. Been here for about, since 1962. So that's what, 40 years? It was a wreck when I got it. So I spent 30 years building it up.
What year was it, 1942? Is it just after Pearl Harbor?
Well, December 7th was my birthday, the 18th birthday. That was the day it started.
We were picked up, taken to a train station, and shipped off to Santa Anita Racetrack. Outside of Los Angeles. There we were put in the family. That was the family. It was my mother, my sister, my two younger brothers. Five of us, we were put into a stall which had housed one horse before. We stayed there for 6 months, and then we were broken up again. There were 18,000 people in Santa Anita. The government had constructed 10 relocation camps in 10 different parts of America. We got shipped to Poston, Arizona, which was close to the California border on a Indian reservation. We were put into tar paper barracks.
I just wanted to get out of camp, and I thought, I take my chances. And this is training. In some books, they say this is going into battle, but actually this was still in Mississippi. We were training. This is me.
I was making a very large iron sort of structures covered with plaster, very big sort of abstract figures. I had the visit of three guys from Amsterdam, three Dutch painters who were looking for young artists to participate in a big show in Amsterdam because they had been given the possibility of taking over the whole museum and doing an exhibition. So they were inviting guys that they felt were experimental, and I was one of the guys that they invited, and so I said I would very happily expose, and I went up to Amsterdam with my sculptures, and I found out that this was the nucleus of this whole exhibition was a group called Cobra. Was CO was Copenhagen, BR was Brussels, and A was Amsterdam. And this was going to be the first exhibition of Cobra.
Well, a lot of the sculptures are not here at the moment. They're still in an exhibition which ends, I think, in 10 days. There are about 600 sculptures, big cases, that are coming back next week or in 10 days. There are these sculptures here. This is a series that I've written about in the Red Book, about the 47, the Rowan, the 47 samurais who committed suicide, which is time which I'm busy with.